Hey everyone, welcome back to the Canadian PA channel. Today I want to talk about what exactly is a PA and what do we do. To tackle this, I want to look at a couple things. First of all, I just want to look at the hospital workflow of how tissue goes from surgery up to the lab and then a diagnosis is made. I want to look at what our level of involvement is in that, some other duties that we have, and then some things that we do not do. All right, so first off, hospital workflow. When a patient goes in for surgery and some tissue is removed, either for a biopsy, maybe a weird mole is taken off, or maybe it's something more major like a lung or a breast is removed or a big piece of cancer is cut out, that tissue is sent to the lab, and that's where we live and exist. And then from there, that big piece of tissue is sort of cut up, put into smaller pieces called sections, and then those sections get turned into little thin pieces of tissue that get mounted on a glass slide. Those slides get stained so the cells in them have a bit of coloration, and then a pathologist will receive those slides. They'll look them under a microscope, and then based on the size of the cells, the shape or arrangement, and how close they come to the edges of the tissue, they actually make a diagnosis based on that, and then the surgeon gets a report saying, you know, this tissue has blah, 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 either disease, no disease, or the tissue is, you know, away from all the surgical cuts. And then the surgeon will guide his future treatment based on that. All right, number two, what does it look like when tissue arrives in the lab? So we're part of the team that does the macroscopic observation of any tissue that arrives. So we don't actually do really any microscopic work, so using a microscope. Pretty much everything that we do involves actually looking at the tissue with our eyes and talking about what we see. So when things first arrive in the lab, we'll get a requisition with patient information along with a little specimen container, either fresh or in formalin. And the first thing we're gonna do is actually make sure that what's described in the requisition matches with the tissue that we've actually received. So if the requisition says liver wedge, we just wanna make sure that we've actually received a liver wedge. From there, we're going to decide if any extra testing needs to be done on the tissue. Sometimes little pieces of tissue need to be sent off to other departments for extra testing. So we'll evaluate whether or not that needs to be done and do so. Sometimes the tissue will arrive fresh. Other times it comes in formalin already. We usually gross tissue after it's been fixed in formalin for a while. So any fresh tissue, we will ourselves place in formalin. Usually big pieces of tissue, so really, really large specimens or fatty tissues will actually have to cut before they can go into formalin, and that's just so everything can soak into all the pieces. Things like really fatty tissue or really thick tissue formalin won't penetrate all the way into without us doing that first off. Then typically the next day, once tissue has been fixed and is ready to gross, that's the bulk of what we actually do in the lab, is the grossing part. And what that is a report that we usually end up dictating that includes a bunch of information about the tissue organ that we have. So that information is going to include patient identifiers and any information. It will talk about the actual type of tissue that we have and the procedure that was performed, if we can tell. And then we're going to talk about just the tissue appearance. So its size, its weight, its color, its texture, its consistency, and then even if it looks normal or not. From there, we might take some photographs, and if there's any orientation that the surgeon has provided, usually with sutures to mark maybe superior, lateral, or if what they took out was next to another important organ, we'll note that orientation as well. And then from there, we'll actually put a bunch of cuts into the tissue and essentially dissect the tissue to see what the cut surface looks like. Often, if there's a tumor or some kind of infection or even necrosis in the tissue, that's something that we can see with our eyes, and that's something that we'll measure. Again, talk about the appearance and also include how close that comes to the margins of the tissue, so where the surgeon actually cut. And that's a big part of what we're doing. We're just making sure that the surgeon actually got all of the tumor. And if we can see it with our eyes, then the pathologist will definitely see it down the line on their microscope. From there, once we've described everything that we can see, we're actually going to take little sections of tissue, and those are large coin-sized pieces of tissue that go into plastic containers called cassettes, and those will go for processing. After they're processed, they'll get cut extremely thinly and mounted on a glass slide. that's what will get stained, and then the pathologist will receive those slides and look at the cells underneath and issue a diagnosis based on that. So our role in grossing is actually quite vital, because we're providing the slides basically that the pathologist will see and base their diagnosis on. So if we do a poor job grossing, the pathologist can only diagnose what they see on the slides. So their ability to diagnose well and accurately is largely dependent on the tissue that we provide them. All right, number three, other lab duties. So while grossing is the kind of main part of what we do on a day-to-day basis, it's maybe 80 to 85% of our time in the lab, there are some other things that we deal with on a day-to-day basis as well. One of those being frozen sections or intraoperative consults. This is really the only stat or rush thing that we have to deal with in pathology. And what that is when a patient is in surgery and the surgeon is about to maybe cut out a tumor, or they're trying to remove some tissue and they're worried about if they're basically getting all of the tumor itself. So if this little ball was a tumor, they'll take a little shave of tissue from over here and they'll send it up to us and say, you know, quickly let me know if there's any cancer in that edge. And we'll do a bunch of stuff, let them know that, oh, no cancer here, you're fine to cut on this side. And they'll do that from all around the edges of the tissue. And if one of those comes back positive, that just tells them, oh, cut a little bit further this way or a bit deeper. And it actually is kind of real-time feedback on whether or not they're getting all of the tumor. Now, those aren't done on all cases, usually ones that have a very small margin of error, so maybe anything in the face or the mouth, that's one that gets a lot of frozen sections. But we're involved in that quite often to get that quick kind of turnaround to let the surgeon know that they're good or not. Another thing that we're involved with is autopsy. So in addition to just actually performing the autopsy itself, we usually end up running the morgue. So that's any kind of setup or cleanup for autopsy cases, releasing bodies to funeral homes, prepping bodies for family viewings if they do so wish it. And we also do a bit of training for pathology residents, and if we have any other students, like PA students that are there, we'll be involved in that as well. And then the last kind of other lab duty that we might have is if a pathologist or surgeon is doing any kind of tissue or research banking, we'll usually be involved in that and just ask to take tissue when available. And that's usually at our discretion. We have to make sure that there's, first of all, enough tissue for the pathologist to make a diagnosis. So if we get a really small piece of tissue that can't actually, you know, we can't give tissue to research banking and make a diagnosis, we'll say, you know, sorry, not enough tissue here, try again next time. So that is something that we're also involved in. All right, fourth, what we don't do or what we aren't really involved in. So first and foremost, a pathologist assistant is not involved in diagnosing any disease. We will provide a bunch of the description and information as well as tissue for pathologists to make a diagnosis, but we don't actually diagnose. So we're not signing out cases. We're trying not to include diagnostic terms in our descriptions. That's all in the realm of the pathologist. Next, we don't deal with patients, really. Pathology is a discipline that doesn't really deal with patients on the whole, but that's definitely something that we don't do, and our involvement in talking to surgeons is fairly limited. The pathologists, since they're the one making a diagnosis, are usually the ones that are communicating with the rest of a patient's healthcare team. It's not to be said that we never talk to surgeons, but the bulk of that communication happens between the pathologists themselves and the surgeons. We also don't do research. There may be research projects that are ongoing in your lab that pathologists are overseeing or other doctors are a part of, and they may ask you to, you know, help out here and there, but by and large, we're not doing research, unless it's on your own time and it's something that you're choosing to do, but it's not typically a part of your usual job duties and expectations. Fourthly, while we are PAs, we are not physician assistants. We are pathologist assistants. I've seen that confusion arise somewhere. Some other places I've seen us described as medical lab techs, medical lab assistants, phlebotomists, phlebotomist assistants. Those aren't us. We are strictly within the realm of pathology and deal with surgical tissue before it goes for diagnosis. All right, so hopefully that gave you guys a good idea of what a PA does on a day-to-day basis. Quick wrap-up, what we do, we're part of the lab team that's involved in examination of surgical specimens and are sort of the middleman between surgery, where tissue is removed, and a pathologist when a final diagnosis is made. We also have a hand to play when a surgeon needs a real-time feedback for if they need to keep taking out tissue or if they're good to stop a surgery. We're involved in the kind of morgue and autopsy duties. We perform the bulk of eviscerations and also are responsible for setup and cleanup of the morgue itself. And lastly, we don't have any direct diagnostic ability to make calls on cases. That's all in the realm of the pathologist. Hopefully that gives you an idea of kind of what the PA job is, what to expect, and what you could be doing if you are working as a PA. Thanks guys for tuning in, and I'll catch you next time.